movement at the station, for the word had passed around that the colt from old regret had got away and had joined the wild bush horses. He was worth £1,000, so all the cracks had gathered to the fray. All the tried and noted riders from the stations near and far had mustered at the homestead overnight. For the bushmen love hard riding where the wild bush horses are, and the stock horse snuffs the battle with delight. There was Harrison, who made his pile when Pardon won the cup, and the old man with his hair as white as snow. But few could ride beside him when his blood was fairly up. He would go wherever horse or man could go. And Clancy of the Overflow came down to lend a hand. No better horseman ever held the reins, for never horse could throw him while the saddle girths would stand. And he learned to ride while droving on the plains. And one was there, a stripling, on a small and weedy beast. He was something like a racehorse undersized, with a touch of time or pony, three parts thoroughbred at least, and such as are by mountain horsemen prized. He was hard and tough and wiry, just the sort that won't say die. There was courage in his quick, impatient tread, and he bore the badge of gameness in his bright and fiery eye, and the proud and lofty carriage of his head. But still so slight and weedy, one would doubt his power to stay. And the old man said, that horse will never do. For a long and tiring gallop, lad, you'd better stop away. Those hills are far too rough for such as you. So he waited sad and wistful, lonely Clancy stood his friend. Oh, I think we ought to let him come, he said. And I warrant he'll be with us when he's wanted at the end. For both his horse and he are mountain bred. Oh, he hails from Snowy River, up by Kosciuszko's side, where the hills are twice as steep and twice as rough, where a horse's hooves strike firelight from the Flintstones every stride, and the man that holds his own is good enough. And the Snowy River riders on the mountains make their home, where the river runs those giant hills between. I have seen full many horsemen since I first commenced to roam, but no way yet such horsemen have I seen. So he went, they found the horses by the big mimosa clump. They raced away towards the mountain's brow. And the old man gave his orders, boys, go at 'em from the jump. No use to try for fancy riding now. And Clancy, you must wheel them, try and wheel them to the right. And ride boldly, lad, and never fear the spills. For never yet was rider that could keep that mob in sight if once they gained the shelter of those hills. So Clancy rode the